Alright, hello world and welcome to a brand new Azure vlog. First of all, Happy New Year. I know I'm a little bit late, but still, Happy New Year to those of you watching this one. And today I would like to talk about Azure Sentinel and its connection with a Git repository. This connection can give us quite a good control when you want to manage Azure Sentinel on a large scale, standardize a lot of things, and make the quality of your management of Azure Sentinel a lot better. So without further ado, let's dive into the theory, and later on we have some demos, of course. So Azure Sentinel plus GitHub is love. By combining Git repositories, in this case I'm choosing for GitHub, but Azure DevOps is also supporting, we can accomplish a lot of good things in Azure Sentinel. We can manage it at scale. So what are the challenges that you might experience? Well, if you are working with Azure Sentinel in the GUI, there is actually no traceability on changes that you execute on Azure Sentinel content. And with content, I mean the alert rules, threat hunting rules, automation rules, all that kind of stuff. There's also no standardization of content when using multiple workspaces. So if you're dealing with multiple workspaces, for example, you have multiple Azure Sentinel workspaces spread over the world, and you have a workspace in Australia, one in West Europe, and one in the UK. There's probably no standardization in it. You might do a lot of things in the same way, but there's no standardization in place. It's hard to manage those Azure Sentinel workspaces at scale. So when you're a big company and you have a lot of Azure Sentinel workspaces, it might be challenging to manage the content of those workspaces, to make sure that all those workspaces, the same analytic rules, the same alert rules, etc., is available over there. And last but not least, a lot of time is spent in the GUI, the user interface of Azure Sentinel, by clicking with the keyboard and mouse. We can do that a lot smarter. So what do you want? You want to have a standardized configuration over all your Azure Sentinel workspaces. By doing so, you know that alerts coming from a workspace always mean the same thing, because all the alert rules are configured in the same way. The same for threat hunting rules, etc. You want to have a configuration that can be applied at scale. So just with one click of a button, you want to update all your Azure Sentinel workspaces instead of just one. And one thing that I also think that you want is use a version control system. By having a version control system, you have traceability of changes that are happening on analytics rules, on alert rules, and all the stuff that you're using. And I'm not saying that this is needed from a auditing kind of perspective, but also to know why a change has happened. When you're working with a version control system, you need to commit data to the version control system, and there's most of the time a commit message required. And that message, you can write why you put that change in the repo. And that brings a lot of traceability, and of course, also the audit is available. Last but not least, we don't want to repeat ourselves. So when we're dealing with a lot of Azure Sentinel workspaces, we don't want to go in the Azure portal. We don't want to configure all the workspaces manually. That costs us a lot of time. Creating a rule, if you have everything defined, well, it takes about a couple of minutes, right? If we have the query, etc., all available in, let's say, Notepad, we can copy paste it in there, but then still it will cost us a couple of minutes. So we can do that better. And Azure Sentinel helps us with that. Or I must say Microsoft helped us with this a lot with a new feature, which is currently under preview. And it allows us to connect Azure Sentinel to Azure DevOps or GitHub to a Git repository. And we can have our content, so the analytic rules, threat hunting rules, automation rules, we can have it all in that workspace and deploy. We can all have it in that GitHub repo, and from there we can deploy to multiple Azure Sentinel workspaces. So the Git repositories provide traceability, as I mentioned earlier, not just only for auditing purposes, but also to get answer on the question, why is this analytic rule changed? And of course, last but not least, we have pipelines to deploy our content, our configuration to a workspace. And we can trigger that pipeline to deploy to multiple workspaces. That's great. So the situation that you end up when you're connecting Azure Sentinel to a Git repository is that all your analytics rules, your automation rules, hunting queries, playbooks, and workbooks are in a GitHub repo or Azure DevOps repo. From there, we have a pipeline or in GitHub action that deploys to the Azure Sentinel workspace. It will automatically create the analytic rule or automation rule, whatever content of your like, in Azure Sentinel. So you don't have to do that by yourself manually. So let's grab a good cup of coffee and I'll show you how you can connect GitHub to Azure Sentinel and show you all the good stuff that it will bring us. So that was a really good cup of coffee. So let's get into the Azure portal and I'll show you around. So what you see over here is my Azure Sentinel workspaces. I'm in the analytics part. As you can see, this is almost an empty Azure Sentinel workspace. Only one analytic rules in here, the advanced multi-stage attack detection is in there. If we go over here, I have my GitHub repo where I have a Azure Sentinel repository created with an empty README file. You can see it over here. And a analytic rule, which notifies me when rare Azure activities are taking place. So let's go back to the Azure portal. If we go over here in the menu, there is an item called repositories. and stated that it's still under preview. So here we can connect our Git repository to Azure Sentinel. At this moment, there's only support for GitHub and Azure DevOps. So if I click on the add new over here, I can create a new connection, a connection to my Git repository. I call it GitHub connection. Connection to the Azure Sentinel GitHub repo. For the description and the control that I'm using is GitHub. Let's click on authorize. And that's going quite fast, as I've already authorized it before. It's quite simple. You click on authorize, a pop-up will pop up where you can log in with your Git credentials, and then you can you select a repository over here. So I have my Azure Sentinel repo over here. I can click on a branch over here, and the type of content that I would like to sync are the analytics rules. And when I click on create, it's now setting up the connection for me. We can monitor the progress over here. So what's it's doing? It's creating the connection, but also adding some stuff to my my GitHub over here. When I go to my GitHub page and click on actions, you see that an action is running. It's running the first deployment. In GitHub, an action is comparable with a pipeline in Azure DevOps. So it will take all the analytics rules for this action and pushes them to Azure Sentinel. So if I go to code, you can see what Azure Sentinel created for me. We have an Azure Sentinel deploy.ps1 and we have a workflow file. And these files contain all the logic that automatically will push analytics rules that I create over here in my GitHub repo. So when you are looking at a analytic rule, it's quite a complex file. But I can show you a trick that will make creating those files much easier. So if I go to analytics, I click create a new scheduled rule. Just a normal sample rule. This is a sample rule, so it will be quite a simple one. Azure activity limit 100. Not allowed. Limit 10. Yes, that's accepted. So if I rush through this wizard, imagine that I've created a really cool, awesome rule right now. I can select my sample rule and I click export over here. And this will download a file. And that file I can upload to the Git repo. So let's say I will delete this one. And go back to my Git repo. For those who don't know, if you click the dot button on your keyboard, Git will automatically start a Visual Studio Code editor in your browser, which I think is really awesome. So if I go on my other screen over here to my downloads, I can upload the just downloaded file, which is the sample rule. If I click on create a new change, add sample rule, click on commit over here. If we go back to the GitHub overview, if it's working, we click on actions, we can see that it's running. As you saw earlier, I deleted my sample rule. And as soon as this action is completed, the sample rule will be back in my Azure Sentinel workspace. So this is quite awesome if you ask me. Let's hit refresh. No, not there yet. We can click on the deploy content over here to see all the steps that is working, that is working on. So we are now logging into Azure. It's done. It's doing all kind of stuff right now. It's basically all the output of the PowerShell that that provides the connection to Azure Sentinel. Check out. So it's now checking out the repo. It's now deploying to Azure Sentinel. This can take a minute. I see the provision status succeeded. I think we are finished now. Yes, green check mark. If I refresh over here, the sample rule is back. So by using the import and the export tools over here, we can easily create those complicated JSON files which store the analytic rule. I think that's amazing and pretty cool. So in this video, you saw how we can use Azure Sentinel in combination with a Git repository, especially GitHub in my demo. It will help us standardizing our content. We can define the content one time in a Git repo and deploy it to multiple Azure Sentinel workspaces. With that standardization also comes scalability. We can deploy our content in the same way to multiple workspaces. So if you're dealing with multiple workspaces, this will make your life much easier. With that, I hope you liked this video. If so, please hit the thumbs up button. Also subscribe to my channel. And of course, I'll see you in the next one. Bye. We'll be right back.